Hello.
Hi.
So here we are today, and we're going to kind of tip off a little bit from last week, Pastor Rob's message, because it was so good, right?
Yes, it
and
was good.
He talked about the love of God. If you didn't get a chance to listen to it, you can go back and listen to last week's broadcast, because it was off the hook. This week, we wanted to kind of focus on one of the things he shared about that really stood out to us, and that was when he said, when God created Adam, he gave him the kiss of life, breathing his very breath into him.
Yes.
How awesome was that?
I just love that. Can you imagine God kissing Adam and breathing his very breath of life into him? That's called the love of God. How much God loves humanity that he just kissed him and breathing in his very life.
Amazing. One of the things I was thinking on was how everyone has a different experience, how they come to know the Lord or how they meet the Lord, or we call it being born again or saved, right?
Right.
And I was thinking how some have this like wow moment, and it's like they just know they gave their heart to the Lord, right?
Right.
Some people know the date, the time, what they were wearing, where they were. And then there's people that say, well, I don't really know exactly what the date was, but I just know God was starting to work on my heart and things, something was starting to change, right? Everyone's testimony is different.
Right.
But I was thinking of your story, Mom, and what happened to you, because you didn't go to a service. You didn't go up for a quote altar call, as they call it, and, you know, say, Lord, come into my heart. You didn't pray a specific prayer, so to speak. What happened to you?
Well, what happened to me was I was searching for knowledge, and it was not really the knowledge of God. I was just searching. I wanted to know things.
Hmm.
And I prayed. I said, God, I want to know things. And I started to see all these books, you know, and philosophies. And wouldn't you know it, I had this big Bible at home right there on the shelf all the while. And I picked it up and I started to read the Gospels of Jesus' life. And so I no longer just talked to God.
Mm.
When I prayed at night, I had a prayer where I knew I was talking to Jesus.
Mm.
And the neat thing about that is the Bible does say Jesus is the only door to God.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, there's millions of religions all over the world, and people praying to God, but the scriptures say in the Gospels of Jesus Christ that he is the way to God, he's the truth, and he's the life we need, right?
Right.
God kissed us with the breath of his life. And so I talked to Jesus this one night, and that's when I had this encounter where Jesus talked back to me, and it was very real. Because I heard him in a voice inside myself saying, if you want me in heaven, you can't continue to live this way, which what I knew right away, it was with all my boyfriends and having sex before marriage and all these relationships that were not of God.
Mm-hmm.
And I had to make a decision that night, because he made it very plain to me I wouldn't have heaven if I kept up that type of life, and I wouldn't have him. And I believed in Jesus from a little child,
mm-hmm.
being raised a Catholic, and so I wanted Jesus, and I had to make a decision right then. And I decided, well, I might as well give Jesus a shot. I tried all that other stuff and nothing bring me peace or happiness. No, none of those guys put a ring on my finger to say, I love you for the rest of my life. I'm going to take care of you. But anyhow, that's how I had my encounter. And when I said, okay, Jesus, I guess I'll give you a shot. And I meant it. And I said, well, I guess it's just going to be me and my two children, because I had two children at the time, but no husband. And the minute I said that, I felt the presence of God for the first time in my life. And it started, you know, like at the bottom of my feet and just came up. And what happened to me, Robin, is I had a deliverance, because I was in into many occult things, from the astrology, Ouija board, tarot cards. I was really into that stuff, and dreams from not from God. So that all left, and God came in. And I'm telling you, there's no feeling like it. And basically, how you know that you're a child of God, that you really got a new birth inside from God, the scriptures say the Spirit bears witness, which is God's Spirit, when he comes in, bears witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. And that's what I got saved with Jesus when I was 26, and now I'm like 68. And all those years, he's always been with me. And if I ever had a doubt, or I hear someone else saying, yeah, well, if there is a heaven, I'll look at them and say, hey, the Spirit bears witness with our spirit that we are God's children. And you can always lean back on that, because you know and you remember the day you really had an encounter with Jesus and got connected back to God.
So we think about, right, how we were saying everyone kind of has this experience. Everyone has their own testimony, their own way of how it happens. But how can somebody say they know that they know they're going to heaven, that they're a son of God or a child of God now? You know, how can they be sure?
Well, if I ask someone, where are you going to go when you die? And they hesitate and say, well, I hope heaven. Chances are they're thinking that they're weighing their good things from their bad. And so hopefully God will accept me. And that's not the way it works. But if you say heaven right away when I ask that question, that's the person that had the experience, because they know the Spirit of God that came in them bears witness with their spirit that God gave them that new birth in their spirit.
Yes.
And that's how I know the person had this experience. Because if you're hesitating, saying, I hope isn't going to get you there.
So it's a confidence is what we're saying. There's a confidence that comes inside of us to say, hey, I know I'm forgiven.
Right.
I know who I used to be. But now, and one of the things I love that you always say, Mom, too, is that God loved us in all of our mess. He comes to the person, not because you're so great or you're so good even, but just your little bit of hunger that you were starting to have for God at the age of 26, where you opened up your big Catholic Bible, took it off the shelf, began to read the Gospels, which is Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, the four Gospel accounts of Jesus. And all of a sudden, she started to have a talk with Jesus. So whatever your testimony is and how you come to know Christ, all of a sudden you begin to get a confidence that I belong to God. I am loved and forgiven, right?
Right, exactly. Now, when I had my experience with the Lord when I was 26, before Jesus came in and I received him and responded to turn away from my lifestyle that was not pleasing to God, and I felt all this stuff leave me that was evil, and God come in, there is no love like the love of God. I tell you, when God is love, the Bible says, but when you feel God, when you really feel his presence come inside, I was so overwhelmed because I was so empty before. I was so alone. All this stuff I was into that's basically demonic, that it's a spirit thing, but it's from evil spirits. They're not from God, who's a spirit. And when that all left me by Jesus coming in, his spirit, I don't care. And I agree with women, you know, on Facebook that say you're the best thing to their husbands that ever happened to me. Yes, so is my husband. But none of that can compare to the love of God, our creator, when he comes to live inside. There is no love like it. And all I can say, when that happened to me and I felt God, I was on a honeymoon. I actually felt like I was floating for a week, feeling this, smiling, and just laying back and saying, God, how could you love me? Because I was a bad person. Now, I've been saved for many, many years, and people think I was always that. But when you hear what I used to be, I was bad. I could write a book on how bad I was. Okay, yes. That's another story. But I really was a bad person. Wild as can be. Loved sin. Sin was the greatest thing. The pleasures that you have from it. But none of it filled me. No alcohol or drugs can give you a high like the Most High. And I would say, God, how could you love me? This is so beautiful. This is what I was always searching for in men and could never find it. This is the love that I found that I don't want to ever lose. And I'm 68 now, and I've never lost it, because God's love, you cannot compare it with any human love. It is just magnificent, and it grows because you learn to know God not only as your first love, but as a loving father, a compassionate father, a forgiving father, one who's not going to divorce you, one who's not going to leave you, one who's there in your darkest moments. And I've had dark moments, Robin. We can agree with that. He's there.
Yes.
And that's the true love that you can bank on into eternity.
Wow. So here we are, right? I'm a believer. You're a believer. You out there, you know, most of you have already had that experience with the Lord, or God's drawing you, right? And so how blessed are we that God loves us so much that he'll appear to each one who is truly searching and seeking.
Right, right. And you know, the scriptures say God's eyes rove to and fro across the whole earth. Seeking someone he can show himself strong to. And believe me, when you meet God for the first time personally, like I did, and Robin and whoever else, you know God's showing himself strong to you.
Yeah.
And the scriptures also say that the road that leads to destruction is wide, and multitudes go there. Okay, because there's so much on that road of destruction that pulls you away from really searching for God. But the road to life is narrow, and though there's very few that find it. If you have had this experience through Christ Jesus, where the Spirit of God has come into you, we're blessed.
Yes.
We are blessed because, you know, the first whole half of the Bible was just for the Jewish people. God chose Abraham, and out of his people, God revealed himself to that nation. And none of the other nations knew the one true God. And still till today, there's millions upon millions of gods that are not gods at all, that the nations pray to or whatever. They have a religion, but not a personal connection or relationship. But when Christ came, the Jewish Christ, God offered the whole world. It said that Jesus came to die for the sins of the whole world. So now the nations are included that were promised to Abraham to be inherited. That's us. We are so blessed to now be a part of the Bible.
Yes.
That we are included in that one holy nation of God's people.
Well, Mom, that was really, really, really awesome. So good. And our prayer today is that if you haven't already, that you would really pray to God and ask Jesus to reveal himself to you, because he will. And your testimony and story is so powerful. And just to say again that he wants to breathe the very breath of his life into you, which brings purpose. And it causes our lives to just be made a new creation where people, you know, it's like you're still you, right? But all of a sudden, it's like, what happened to you?
Yeah, or, you know, you so just, good.
It's like he begins to do the changing. It's not so much like, I got to be good today. I got to do
right,
blah, blah, blah.
Right.
That is not the way it is. It's a relational thing with the Lord. And he begins to write his laws on your heart.
Right.
And now you're convicted when you do wrong. And that's, we could go on about this, but pray to the Lord. Ask him. Say, Lord, I want to know you. Reveal to me your son Christ. And read the words of the Holy Scripture, Matthew, Mark, Luke, St. John's account, all those accounts.
Right, well, all the accounts of Jesus' disciples yeah. that walked with
yes.
him.
Yes, and your life will never be the same. So remember, the love of God, let it today fill those empty places in your life because we all need filled up by God. Amen? Good stuff, right, Mom?
Absolutely.
You got a joke for us? And with
how about you?
No, I really don't. Just didn't know if you had one. Let's think. We'll tell you what a real joke is. That the whole time we've been filming, there's been a little critter.
You want to say hi, Chip? Come here. Come say hi to the people. Chip, come here. Don't be ashamed. You're free.
I do this thing with Chip, and I say, Chip, come to the altar. Watch this. Chip, come. You need to give your heart to the Lord. A little
come
rebellious.
On, repent. So Chip, repent you, from
no,
peeing on Robin's
I'll
towels.
Say, Chip, do you repent today? And I put my hand up, and of course he jumps up. And right, we sing to him, my Jesus. And he comes up to the altar, my Savior. We love you guys. Have a great week. Well, we pray that you enjoyed this week's broadcast. And next week, we can't wait to see you again. Remember to go online. Check us out on our website at laborloveusa.org. We always post up all the broadcasts. And you can see all the ministry work that we do there. Thank all of you for sending in offerings. We just really cannot thank you enough. So whether you go online or mail it in to 3215 North 5th Street in East Stroudsburg, Pennsylvania, where God lives, 18301. See what I did there? All right, guys, have a great, victorious week, and we'll see you next time.